This is Carding Anticipation. And before I show you the colors that I've chosen for anticipation, I want you to close your eyes and think about anticipation. Is it a positive emotion or a negative? How do you feel once the thing you have anticipated is here or comes true? Have you ever anticipated more than something actually was worth? Does anticipation usually result in happiness or disappointment? And just kind of chew on that idea for a bit, because each of these emotions can be positive and negative, and I'm going to be carding both sides of it into each bat for more dimension. So I had several friends of mine come over a few weeks ago to help me come up with all of these colorways, because I didn't want to have it all be my own point of view. I wanted to see how other people felt about color. And this is what they came up with for anticipation. Anticipation starts with, you don't have anything to anticipate and life is calm. And then, let's see, something happens and you start building up anticipation for it. You start building and building and building, and then you feel like you're almost going mad from anticipation. And then the thing happens, and maybe you're a little bit disappointed because it wasn't as good as you thought it would be. But life becomes calm again. So that is my color story using the colors that my friends picked out. Calm of life, anticipation grows, it happens, you're a little bit disappointed, and then life returns to how it was before. So now let's card this into an art bat and try to also represent the texture and the dimension of anticipation in our bat. This is the drum carder that I use for all of my carding series. It is a Louet Classic. It's the only carder I've ever had, and I love it. I have a theory with carding that art bats are kind of like sourdough bread. I like to keep my drum carder dirty and add those flecks and odd little bits and pieces from other bats into each bat as it goes. And it kind of creates a journey from one bat to another, which I like. So I've got some here that some of you may recognize from another bat on my YouTube channel called Beachcomber. So I'll put a little bit of Beachcomber on here just to remember, oh, the beach, that's nice. Maybe we're anticipating going to the beach. So I'm going to blend this. Well, I did Beachcomber top to bottom. So maybe I'll do this layered. So we're gonna start with a bottom layer of white for how life feels every day, the normalcy of life. Happy normalcy. You get up in the morning, you get your cup of coffee, life is good. You check your email. Maybe your friend emails you and is like, hey, let's go do this fun thing. And you're like, oh, that's a great idea. Put it on the calendar. So then, anticipation. Anticipation is like, maybe I'll meet someone there. Maybe something magical will happen. Maybe I'll fall in love. Maybe my dreams will come true. Maybe this is the answer that I'm looking for. Maybe. Or you could think maybe something bad will happen. maybe it won't be fun. Maybe I shouldn't have committed. And finally, I'm totally stoked. I can't wait to do this thing. It's gonna be super fun. Super fun, super fun. Maybe I feel like I've been anticipating this forever. Okay, so now, where's my brush? There it is. So I'm gonna pack this down using my brush so I can fit the rest of this journey on here. Okay, so then the moment happens. And I'm gonna put the moment at the top because it's a high. Maybe this is like when your baby is born, or when you walk down the aisle, or when you graduate, or when you've worked really, really, really hard for that thing. You know what we need? We need more of that. So we're gonna add some more shiny yellow mohair. This is what you have anticipated. You've worked so hard for it, and we need this to sparkle. Let me go grab some sparkle. Yeah, this is what it is. That moment, that super awesome moment that you have been looking forward to, I think that moment is holographic sparkle. It's like, yes, are you kidding me? This is amazing. Life is great. What? I'm going to remember this forever. And then there's the little bit of like, oh, it's over. It's done. It's finished. That was fun. Maybe a little bit of sadness covers over that time period because you're like, oh, wasn't it fun to anticipate? Wasn't that fun? I think, to me, the anticipation of an event is often more fun than the event itself. And life slowly gets back to normal and becomes peaceful. Maybe your life, because my life always goes back to white. I mean, obviously, I'm surrounded by white. I love white. White's been my favorite color for ages. But maybe your life doesn't go back to white. What color is your life? But yeah, my life goes back to white. And man, that holographic sparkle is super fun. Yeah. And it goes back where you have the memories. The memory of the anticipation and the memory of it happening, but a lot of the buildup, a lot of the story you forget. You forget. A lot of it's forgotten. And all you're left with is memories of that moment. So yeah, that to me is the journey of anticipation. So let's put our handle facing downward so that our little wooden groove is on top, and we'll take this bat off and take a look at it. You can apply these journeys and these questions and moods to any time in your life where you are working with color and fiber arts. So you can use these same ideas for your dye pots or any fiber blending tools, fiber prep that you do. So this is the folded bat, and I'm gonna unfold it so we can see the whole journey of anticipation. Okay, this is the top of anticipation, and here's the bottom. If you enjoyed this tutorial, you can check out my website at howtospinyarn.com. I'm also on Etsy as How to Spin Yarn, and on my Etsy shop, I have individual moods tutorials for you to choose from, or you can sign up for the entire class of 20 moods and card through to create your own unique colorways based on your life experiences. Thank you so much for watching, and happy carding!